Hey folks, this is Best in Slot with yet more really exciting paleo media news. We cannot stop winning this year. There is so much good content on the way. Really exciting time to be into paleo media in general. It's not Attenborough and the Sea Dragon, however. That was a 60-minute short film kind of thing documentary brought out in 2018. Let me just scratch that off there. There we go. It's Attenborough and the Giant Sea Monster. So let's dig in and let's find out all about this. BBC Factual announces Attenborough and the Giant Sea Monster, working title. Now, I know that's it's a little bit cliche, big spooky monster, kind of thing, but you've got to pull in the general public and punters, you know? A 60-minute film for BBC One and iPlayer, made by BBC Studios Natural History Unit and co-produced by PBS and the WNET Group. So if you're in the US and you know how to access PBS content, I'm not even going to touch on that, I don't know anything, but if you know how to access that content, that's probably how you're going to get hold of it in the United States at the very least. I've kind of just picked out the important information from the press release, which I'll link down below if you want to read it for yourselves. The documentary follows David as he unearths the discovery of a lifetime, the skull of a giant pliosaur, one of the most ferocious Jurassic predators ever known. This enormous prehistoric marine reptile ruled the seas the same time dinosaurs reigned on land, 150 million years ago. Fossil experts believe this pliosaur to be a completely new species, and working at a secret location are setting out on a perilous expedition to excavate the skull and uncover the secrets lying deep within. Filmed on location across the UK, Attenborough and the Giant Sea Monster will combine groundbreaking science with gripping storytelling and state-of-the-art CGI to tell the tale of this most phenomenal predator of the Jurassic world, one that hunted in the seas just off the coast of Britain. So it's going to combine your CGI recreations with your general filming. I'm hopeful we're going to see the skull actually retrieved from the earth, and we get to see the cleanup process and some of that paleontological detail. But either way, a very classic combination of filming styles there. Should be really interesting. And as it says, it's a completely new species. They believe, at least, it's a completely new species of pliosaur. Whether it'll turn out to be that for sort of people who are super into paleontology, we'll have to wait and see, but it is an exciting prospect at the very least. Don't know what it is yet. We don't know what species it is. That's quite interesting. We'll talk a little bit more about pliosaur species in just a second. Finally though, Mike Gunton, executive producer, says, "It's wonderful," I'm not going to do a voice, "it's wonderful to be back on location with David. His eyes absolutely lit up when we told him about this amazing find. He couldn't wait to join the dig and get a first look at the fossil bones for himself." So he's very involved, and it does sound like we are going to have filming footage off the dig itself and off the skull retrieval, which is a really exciting prospect. Mike Gunton may be recognisable as a name to you. He was an executive producer along with Jon Favreau over on Prehistoric Planet. Doesn't necessarily mean too much as an executive producer, but he does seem to be a more hands-on executive producer compared to a lot of them, so the fact that he's involved would suggest that at least this will be a scientifically sound documentary, and I think Attenborough, generally speaking, tends to only lend himself to higher quality work. Unlike a certain Stephen Fry. So, really exciting. It's only a 60-minute episode. You know, it's not like a big event in the way that Prehistoric Planet is, but it sounds like it's going to be scientifically worthwhile. It's got Attenborough behind it. And, you know, for me here in Britain, it's always nice to hear and see recreations and have documentaries about our local critters. So let's talk about pliosaurs a little bit. Pliosauridae is an extinct clade of plesiosaurs, basically, ranging from Jurassic to Triassic. Should be the other way around, really. A diverse group with some resembling plesiosaurs themselves with their sort of longer neck, like Attenboroughsaurus, coincidentally. But generally speaking, you would say pliosaurs are more commonly known for short, stout necks and somewhat crocodile-esque features, is actually where the name comes from, like Chronosaurus here. Funnily enough, this isn't the first pliosaur that Attenborough has unveiled, as he showcased Pliosaurus cavani back in 2013. Another pliosaur found off the coast of Britain, something that in the past was actually thought to be exceptionally rare. Now, as we can see from Pliosaurus cavani, so cavani would be the species, Pliosaurus is the genus, and from the wording of the documentary and the text we've seen already in this video, I get the feeling it's a new species of it's not a Pliosauridae, well it is, but it's also a Pliosaurus, so it'll be Pliosaurus something, species name. Pliosaurus being the genus, cavani being the species, so it'll be Pliosaurus blargablarg-e. It's probably not going to be blargablarg-e, but now I really hope it is. But that's the impression I get, that what we're getting is a new species of Pliosaurus specifically, and not Pliosauridae as a wider clade, basically. Does that make sense? Right, I'm going to do a little thing. So if we kind of stagger it, at the top you've got your plesiosaurs, and then inside that you've got a clade, which is your Pliosauridae, and inside that clade you've got loads of genus, and the genus is Attenboroughsaurus, for example, or Chronosaurus, or Pliosaurus. So Pliosaurus is a genus within Pliosauridae, which is a clade within plesiosaurs, and then Cavani is the species within Pliosaurus. It's kind of like a Russian nesting doll kind of thing. For those of you who are just, it can get a little confusing when you've got like a genus and a clade that have very similar names. It can be a little bit wishy-washy. Either way, really exciting. Yet more really cool sounding paleo media. Yeah, not as big as some of the other stuff coming, but lots of cool people behind it. Interesting subject matter. It's nice to have a focus on aquatic creatures as well, because I feel like that is always a little bit lacking. People like your T-Rexes and stuff like that, you know, the big hitters. But Britain, if there's one thing Britain's really good at in terms of paleontology, it is actually aquatic creatures, so it's really cool to see this. And I'm very curious what the species is and how it's going to fit into the wider, you know, Pliosauridae in general, and Pliosauruses. Potentially. We'll have to wait and see if that turns out to be a correct guess on my part. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Will you be checking out Attenborough and the giant sea monster? And from me, like and enjoy the video. I'll see you lovely folks very soon. Cheers much of as always. Oh, and subscribe. If you're new to the channel, subscribe for the latest in paleo media, video games, documentaries, books soon, hopefully, and all that kind of jazz. Thanks for joining me. Cheers. Much love as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.